A major corporate law firm helped cover up the fact that infants were getting brain damage from contaminated baby formula. Now, let me tell you this, Jones Day. I have worked against Jones Day on more corporate conduct. I mean, the ugliest of the ugliest, Farron. And these folks, it seems like they seek out, they literally seek out the worst clients that they can possibly represent, because those worst clients always pay the biggest amount of money. But this Jones Day, I want to spend a second on this. People don't understand, when we talk about some of the appointments that Democrats make that are no different from Republicans, they don't understand what we're saying. Jones Day is the kind of law firm that defendants, that Democrats go to put on court appointments. That's always gone on, and when we talk about how crazy the Democrats' appointments are, that's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
We're talking about stuff like Eric Holder, for example, coming from Covington Burling in Washington, D.C., where all he did was represented corporate criminals. And no corporate criminal went to jail when he was in charge, no matter how bad the conduct was. But Jones Day is the kind of place they get these people. And I'm not exaggerating. These people, it's a scorched earth attitude. They don't care. They will represent Satan if Satan pays enough money.
That is absolutely the best way to put it. And with this particular case here, I'm really kind of shocked the New York Times went after them as tough as they did in this piece they put out. But we're talking about infants. We're talking about babies that were left with permanent brain damage from contaminated baby formula put out there by Abbott. And what Abbott did, they hired Jones Day, and Jones Day essentially flooded the plaintiff's lawyers with documents. Huge boxes.
Millions and millions of useless documents.
Yeah, and the reason they do that, the useless documents, of course, is the most important part, is they say, okay, you got to go through every one of these now. We'll wait. We'll sit here and drag this out for 7 or 8 years if we have
to. Well, it's not just that. It's not just every one of these silk stocking corporate big firms do this.
Yeah.
They don't just give you a bunch of useless documents. I mean, it takes a staff around here. This is all we handle, are these complex cases. And so we have to staff up and go through 10 million documents. But the truth is, they destroy so many documents. We catch them because there's always a pattern. I mean, it's a very distinctive pattern that we always catch them. But they don't think a thing about destroying documents to say, yeah, we knew this stuff was killing people. Yeah, we kept it out there anyway. And yeah, we made a lot of money. They would think nothing about destroying that document. And unfortunately, the federal courts don't punish them enough every time we catch them. And we catch them all the time. And you say, Judge, really? You're just going to let this go? You're going to, what, hit them for $100,000? These people should lose their license to practice law.
Well, and I think a lot of people need to understand, too, this is why when you have these very complex cases, and the story points out, too, these are little local lawyers. You know, they run their little local commercials. They have a staff of 5 people.
Yeah.
And then suddenly at their doorstep, they end up with 20 million documents to go through. They can't do it for their little local client. And it's so heartbreaking that these families who now have a child that is going to be dependent on them for eternity this tainted baby formula, or maybe it's from a different, you know, agricultural issue or fossil fuel issue, whatever it is, it's the same pattern all over the country.
Farron, can you imagine being the silk stocking lawyer at Jones Day? Okay, you're getting paid your money. They give you a little cubicle somewhere in New York or L.A. You're sitting in your cubicle. You come home, and it's a victory. You proclaim victory because you kept that mother from getting paid for the loss of her child or for the brain damage that product caused the baby, where the mother has to take care of that child the rest of your life. And you are so upside down. You're just so shallow that you go home with your family and you proclaim you had a good day. You had a victory. What in the hell goes through the mind of somebody like that? We work right across the table from them all the time. The good news is, we usually do pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, you're talking about people that go home and say, honey, it's great. I might make partner because this woman whose baby we killed didn't get any money.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what they celebrate.
And I come back, let me full circle. This is where Democrats go to get their federal judges. This is where Republicans go to get their federal judges. And nobody understands why we're so critical of that system. This is a good example of it right here.